Everybody, welcome back. It is time to check in with the Columbus Metropolitan Libraries. We got Ben Zanitsky with us, and as usual, lots going on at the library. It's summertime, and that really means the pressure's on for the summer reading program.
That's right. You know, Hattie, I wouldn't be rocking a t-shirt on TV unless it was to promote Summer Reading Challenge, Columbus Metropolitan Library's annual program to keep kids reading all summer long. You can log in right this very moment. All you need to do is log on at columbuslibrary.org/summerreading. You can also download the Read Squared app on your smartphone. We're switching it up a little bit this year. You know, it used to be that you would sign up, track your reading throughout the summer, and earn prizes along the way. Well, this year we're going to give you a prize just for signing up, your very own book that we will mail you while supplies last so that you can start tracking your reading with your very own book. And of course, we have wonderful prizes that you can earn along the way. We'll have raffles as you track your reading. You'll be entered into raffles. We'll be giving away 2 bikes along with helmets and locks from each of our 23 library locations. So if I'm doing my math correctly, that's carry the one. That's almost 50 bikes that we're going to be raffling off thanks to our friends from EWI. Also this year, this is kind of fun. At the end of the program, we're going to be raffling off for any participants who finish the program aged 17 and younger, 5 College Advantage savings accounts, each worth $529 from our friends at the Ohio Tuition Trust Authority. So that's new and exciting. And we'll have great gift cards to be raffled off as well for all age groups to Target and to other local places like restaurants and bookstores and things like that. All you need to do is sign up. And it is so, so important that you keep kids reading and you model reading for kids. You can read aloud to your youngest and that counts. So track your reading and get reading this summer.
Wait, you can read aloud to your youngest?
Absolutely.
Meaning like how old?
There is no age limit. As soon as a baby is born, reading to that baby is important because you're also, they're hearing the sound of your voice. This is how babies learn language. So absolutely, reading to your babies counts. Reading cereal boxes counts. We just want you to read. We're not going to assign you the Great Gatsby, you know, or the Scarlet Letter. We just want you to read.
Yeah, I can see how reading my 2-year-old The Great Gatsby might be a little bit out of his age range, but you never really know. He could totally be a genius. So that is really exciting. That's something for parents to get excited about too. Just, you know, hearing those incentives, they're already reading to their kids every day. And if they're not, now they're going to be. What else do you have going on at the library?
Goodness, we have a whole great slew of virtual events that are going along with our summer reading challenge. You can visit our website, columbuslibrary.org/summerreading. Again, we'll have free virtual events all summer long. Today, we just made live a mad science program where you can perform science experiments right from your own home, along with scientists who will guide you. So tons of fun stuff coming up. We also have dancing and storytelling. So we hope that you'll join us. It's absolutely free. You don't need a library card, but we always say it's the most valuable card in your wallet, and it's a great time to sign up for one.
Was that virtual storytelling and things like that?
Yes, all virtual.
And now I do have to ask you, because I'm asking everybody now that the COVID restrictions are really starting to lighten up, what's it going to start looking like at the library? Do you have any plans to change your rules yet?
That's right. Yeah, we do. We're open for business. You can come in, you can browse materials. We're still not yet to a place where you can, reserve a meeting room quite yet. And we're still not holding in-person programs like story times, but we're getting closer. Stay tuned. You can visit our website for more information. In the meantime, we're no longer requiring that customers wear masks inside the library. If you are unvaccinated, we ask that you please continue to wear those masks, our staff will be wearing them as well, unless they have shown that they are vaccinated. So, you know, we're getting closer to normalcy. We hope to see you. We hope you'll stop in. If you still would rather be a little bit more on the cautious side, we have a wonderful, large, and continuously growing collection of eBooks and eAudiobooks that you can download right to your smartphone or tablet. So we hope you'll stay reading no matter how you do it.
And I guess the benefit of going to visit the library in person in the summer months, you got air conditioning.
That's right. We do have air conditioning, and this weekend it is hot.
Yeah. You're going to need it. That's for sure. Ben, thank you so much.